Hi, I'm Chris. In this video of the series about the Ready to Educate cell, we will follow the shape on the table, program a spline block, and use the blending function for points. Let's start.
So now that we actually created our little triangle program, I want to show you how to use several different functions on this shape here on the table. So first, I'm gonna need the pen again. So if I press the play, we'll go and grab the pen, and I wait to have it in my triangle mode. And as soon as I'm here, kind of in the first approach point, I'm going to use again the snap functionality, but with my tool data too. So with the tip of the pen here, and I'm going to snap it in my first corner that I most cylinder and select this table, and therefrom I'm going to add a new function to create this shape. And now I'm going to add a new PTP point and a linear point, and this PTP point is going to be my approach again, and I'm going to retract it in the height or in plus Z again 50 millimeters. And now I'm going to, or you can actually click on the next point, you already have it. And if you want all the way up here in the corner, again, you can use the snap function. Remember, if you want to have the same orientation as the point before. And here again, I'm going to use the shift key and the lower cylinder to select the middle, the very center of the cylinder. And again, click on that. So I'm going to have this lin again, a lin motion to this point. And you see here is we want actually to have a continuous drive. It's called blending, not to touch this next point, but actually to move along the way, all the way to this point here without stopping. Actually, when I show you a short, if I use the shape function here between the take and the bring back, we'll stop at every single point that I have, it will be a full stop. So if I go back in my jog mode and click on this latest point, it will stop here, and I don't want it to stop it on the next point. Either way, I have to teach it. So if I'm going to snap the middle of the next point here with my shift key, 6 to 27, I just put a touch up here. And that if I'm going to snap the middle of the next point here, 7, I don't want to stop here, so I'm going to the statement properties. I'm going to change the blending here to a standard. And what you see right now, so you see it didn't come all the way to the point 27, but had this continuous movement all the way to point 28. And it was kind of tricky to see it. So we're going to add this path visualization, the robot path and geometric path. It will show you what happens here. So it actually goes all the way on the darker gray as we expect it to be, all the way to point 28, and then retracts up. So the next point is actually here a little bit more tricky, because we want to have this curve of the table in it. So what we're going to do is add a circle motion to the third option that you might have here. So if you go back to this tool 2 and you have this snap function going to the next point, add a circular motion. And in the circular motion you see that there are two points. So actually now it created as a point. If we click on it, it's going to be point 30. and it created a spline, which is here a little bit in the middle of nowhere. If we run the program, it's going to jump up here and go back to the point 30. Yeah, so what we now need to do is actually to set this point 29. I'm going to select it point 29 and snap it to this path. Actually, you can also use this touch-up auxiliary point as soon as you have the robot and the right point. We're going to try this the next phase. And if we run the program, we're going to use again a circular motion. So if feature and snap and add a circ. You add it again at point 31 and 32. Then we're going to go back here, a touch up auxiliary point. So we have once the 31, point 31 here, and then 32 here. And again, let's see what happens. It follows exactly the path. So you can have either make this move and select the point whereas you want, or actually use this touch-up auxiliary point. Again, we add a circular movement. We snap directly the endpoint. So I have to make sure that my tool data 2 is selected. I use my set position here, and again, I click on the end of my circular movement, just highlighted here. There we go. Here on, I now create my circ movement in 34. And here now I go back with my snapper again on the curve and click on it and say touch up auxiliary point. So now what should happen? Let's test it again, just to make sure that it works fine. Comes there, runs all the way up to 34. Perfect, looks good. So now you know actually how to create your little path around your robot, and you can continue by doing this point by point movements. What I'd like to show is actually to create a spline block. For that, I'm going to go back to this original point 34 and add here a path spline. And starting here, you have a whole section in your code where actually the spline block will have the same velocity. So I can create here 1 meter per second. I can have a constant orientation, for example, that I select specifically. And with that, I can now create a path. And the first point was actually already set. It's the last point of my circular movement. So it's point 34. And now I continue. Actually, I select the next one. So I snap my tool. I want to have the constant orientation. So I choose this one here. And I click again on a lin movement. And from there on, snap again and choose the last part of my circular movement here and then add circ. And so here again, it's like for the other movements over there, I can snap on the radius of the point and add touch up the auxiliary point. And let's check out what it does. So it actually traced the whole way up to 0.38 in the same speed, and we are going to continue and finish up our little shape here by choosing the last few dots. So again, I'm going back to my 0.38 with my tool data 2, and I'm going to snap again the end point with my shift and the lower tile of the cylinder and say that I want a circular movement here. Again, I have to snap on the path and touch up the auxiliary point. And now I actually, there's still a little curve here, so I have to do this over and over again. But in addition to that, if I don't want to actually set every time a circular path, there is another option, which is here, this SPL. This is a SPL motion, so I can snap on my line here and create the SPL motion. And another one, if I'd snap it here on my cylinder, again, SPL motion, and I finish up kind of the L point, going back to my point 25, snap this point SPL, and finishing up by a PTP up way out of the spline block. So I'm going to collapse this. It's going to have this approach. I can drop my spline block up over the PTP. And if we now look at the path that we created, it gets the pen, it draws this line, continuous movement, and it does my spline block in the same speed as 1 meter per second. I can reduce this to have this a little bit slower. Let's take 0.2 meter per second and run the simulation again, just to being able to see what happens. So it stops at every point, and now it continuous movement here all the way, the long way, and goes up again 2.24 and brings back the pen.
Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to see more interesting videos about KUKA's simulation world, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Looking forward to seeing you in the next video.
Industrial intelligence.